Hey everyone, this is Manly Badass Hero, and welcome back to Narcosis. Previously, things started falling apart as we struggled to survive in a world full of giant crabs. So there is something in front of me. It's the green man, distinct from the blue man or the red man. A couple more colors, we have the entirety of the Power Rangers. Are you host to some kind of bioluminescent plankton? Well, some kind of microorganism. It seems like you're leading the way, though. So hopefully you're good. Or at least chaotic neutral. That's going that way. But there's an exit over here. So let's check this out.
Stand by 5 more minutes. Repeat, we are leaving in 5 minutes. If you're anywhere in range, right now is the time.
Who is that? What's going on? What do we mean we're leaving? Flare. That's weird. It just took us around. I guess there was a pit there. Come on, we can make this jump.
No problem.
In God we trust, everything else gets triple checked. But so much diligence makes every aspect of daily life heavy. Each task or item, like getting into a suit or going outside, has an equivalent weight. So, for getting cargo or yourself over to Compass 2, shuttle's the most efficient option, relatively speaking.
Relatively. It's an anglerfish going around. Hopefully you're not here to bite me also. Bay door locked, shuttle on standby. Flares, pop a few in the area, because we can charge it right here. Unsure if I can reach that. No, we're more of a forward momentum than we are upward. Some O2. Thank you. Through the door. There a corpse. Frozen. No ID detected. Let's warm you up, buddy. That didn't work. I'm sorry. It's a thought that counts. It's out of respect for you. It's out of respect for you. Submarine SAS departed. Was something missing there? Maybe I'm just not seeing things right. Got some flares here while we're here. Why not? Seems to be a huge excess of them. Can't fit for this gap. We're gonna have to like jump this. I'm assuming. I can't really jump this either. Let's back her out then. And see a jump scare. Yes, I was right. We were seeing things. Nice. I'm not crazy. I'm only mildly crazy. Big difference. That's why I couldn't identify the ID, because it was a guilt corpse. One thing I've distinctly noticed, and this is when the game bugged out, and I was trying to burn my oxygen purposely out to die, instead of just reloading and redoing the whole thing. The oxygen doesn't really go down almost at all if you don't move. Don't do anything. So it's inherently, the reason it's at 60% right now is because I'm moving pretty fast. So the more Sonic the Hedgehog you are in relation to Knuckles you are, the faster you'll die. That's how this world works. See it, assess it, fix it, evaluate, review it.
Well, that's a good flower, little bulb. It's a great flower. And a good guy, Kaluka. Oh god, this is a good review.
There's oxygen there, but I don't really need it yet. I'll save it for a return trip if I pass back from here. There's something going on behind me. But it's alright, because I'm gone now. Wait, what was that? Claire! It's just a crab. Yeah, back off. Just go to the flare. Hello, Gilt. Nice to see you too. Smile, you're on camera. Hey, we're all on camera together. Stick around. Cool stuff is coming up. Oh god, that's a lot of crabs. You feeling it now? See the calamari out there. Okay. I think the bay door was the main issue that was holding things up, so let's skedaddle. I don't care about you guys. I'm over my guilt now. Would you listen to that? I'm over my guilt. I'm ready to be cool. Hello, guilt suit. Nice sculpture. A little drama. Can't tell whether the top side Cyclops is winking or just deformed. Like Anders and his ambition, the secret stays there. You're supposed to paint in the eyes. Scooby-Doo!
Come on, come on! You wanna come here?
Didn't have to be like this, man. Could've just walked away. Could've just walked away, man. We've been level F2.
They kept the heat up, but the weight and presence of the ocean, you can't shake that. Gets under your nails and gums like your teeth are coming loose.
Killing sausages at Taco Bell.
And then at some point it recedes. You might not notice that till you're topside, but it's always there.
Probably not dead. These are big crabs.
There's a lot of crabs down here.
Frankly, I don't find them that scary. They actually make me very hungry. There's even a crab in the damn ceiling. What? Like they are very, imagine the meat in those legs. Those are very tasty crabs. I'm sure they want to eat my face, but you know, I want to eat theirs, so it evens out.
No! No, you wanna come on? You wanna go? You wanna go? Come on. You wanna go? Go! That's right. Eat this!
Everything wants to bite. Like, everything just can't leave well enough alone. I could just walk away. I can just walk away. Killed the squids.
Calm down, calm down, calm down! Calm down, they're all dead. What are we even in here for? What's the point of coming in here? Lore. Who was it?
Victor was soft-spoken and almost shy. He couldn't hide the pride he took in every action and accomplishment. Like most of us, all of us, he rarely volunteered information about his past. But it's clear he came for money. After all, we're most cleanly aware of what we've never had. I wonder what his family said when he embarked on a career defined by backbreaking labor and relentless risk. When they learned of his fate, will it be with like pride like his? Or just pity and shame? Pity and shame. Ooh, they're never becoming that body.
Dead or bugged out? Bugged out.
Her name was Eris, but everyone called her Malba. Feisty with a presence that bellied her short stature, or maybe due to it. Although she barely came up to my cadet chest, she kept us on our toes. I found her in the galley. Like all of us, she had a dozen jobs to do, 7 days a week. Not one of those paths where you didn't see her sailing in or storming out of that room, trying to keep us all 20 of us fed. Wherever she's feeding now is probably close by. Nature's is nothing, if not relentless.
Pushing through the calamari, they're already dead. Don't know how, don't care.
So I did. Thought about giving up. With that much time to think about nothing. Just about anyone would. Thing is, the suit's designed to keep you safe, even from yourself. Makes it hard to take the easy way out.
Now what? Repair shuttle. This isn't the objective. No, prep shuttle. Access denied. Not anymore.
Still, does it make it better, knowing how bad things really are? The suit keeps out what you need to be afraid of. Only the fear's trapped in there with you, and it's thriving. So yeah, maybe you're safe and dry, but inside you're drowning.
Oh no. Considering there was just 20 of us in the lab, the intellectual bar was pretty damn high. And luckily, Axe was as sharp as any of us. PhD or not. Which makes it especially tough, piercing together his attempt at outrunning the inevitable. Level head Lucas. Reduce a pure instinct, clambering up and up. The icy water rising up and up. Last moment was in an infantile state. Body contorted from electric shock. Mind unable to grasp the enormity of his newfound circumstance. That's a hell of a way to go. I did not really prepare this base at all. Get that going. Let's keep moving. There is so many crabs. Now let's... come on. Let's go into the secret zone. Grab some flares. Locked and loaded. Can I just kind of launch one of these into the damn fish? Shuttle ready. Later, everybody. It's nice been knowing ya. Hopefully nothing sneaks in with us. Good. Hey, Minty Fresh. Clear that out. Let's see how the progress in the shell is doing.
Signal received. I repeat, signal received. We're headed back to Compass One. Repeat, we're coming back. We are coming to get you.
Huh?
You were prepared, but what happened next caught you completely off guard. Can we talk about that?
Well, first off, I hit a giant sea creature. Didn't really see this coming, but I was in a survival horror game, so to be expected, nothing ever goes easy. But it's what happened after that that I talk about in my recent book, Surviving a Survival Horror Underwater Adventure, that was most important. You can pick up in stores today. Oh, great. Final boss at Phantasy Star Online. Here we go. I'm not sure if anybody will get that reference. Hell of a horizon. Hey, we're not in the suit anymore. I can actually move a little more freely. Comparatively. Going to the light. I still hear myself breathing like I'm in the suit, though. God, I wonder where I'm gonna end up when I wake up. It ain't gonna be pretty. Hey, I've either greatly outwalked the thing, or it's gone. Interesting. Well, I'll just keep walking. Yep. Oh, there's something coming. There's something coming in view. It's a tree. Something's there. Pond. Water. This is where we belong now.
Sorry, can you repeat the question?
I was hoping you'd talk about the moment when you realized that the ones you collided with were, in fact, the ones you were trying to save.
Ah!
It was horrible.
It was like that.
And the odds of us finding them in the first place were poor. I sure as hell didn't expect to run into them. I don't know. I mean, I never found out who was in the other half of the wreck. Not alive, anyway.
God, there's so many pun potentials there. It's funny running into you guys here. What's left of you? Flare out. Bones. I have a feeling this is not the right place to be in. So there is some molten rock there by some thermal vents. There are some angry fish. It's a damn whale graveyard. Here's the head of one. Where do I even begin to... Oh god, the cuttlefish. Where do I begin to go? I'll just keep progressing for the whale graveyard, maybe. Oh, little crab. This is bad. I have no idea where I'm going. I'm extremely disoriented. I am probably gonna die. This is hell. Yeah, we're going down. Turns out being disoriented at the bottom of the ocean is not a good thing. I can only assume the right place I was supposed to go was not anywhere near here. We're going down! It's all downhill from here. No. Seriously, where am I? I should just give up. I don't know. God, the crabs are alive. There's even more crabs. Just go. See, this is actual deep sea horror right here. You're lost. Oxygen dwindling. Things are weird. You're at a dead end. And you've probably gone the wrong way completely. And you kiss your butt goodbye. This is how it goes down. No. This is how it goes down right here. This is how it is. This is how it ends. I'll give it one more go. Come on. Clear it. Yeah. A little more. Come on. No. No.